two. Check one. Check in for sound. One, two.
Farewell, that God would certainly come and help us today. We do need His help. We trust Him to take us through this day, not only this day, but what lays ahead. Praise God. Could we stand for a word of prayer? Shall we pray? Almighty God and our Heavenly Father, we worship you today, and we come to you in the name of your Son Jesus, whom you have sent to die for our sins, so that if we believe, we will not perish but have everlasting life. Oh dear Father, we thank you this morning for all that you are going to do and all that you are going to see. We pray for divine help. We pray for comfort and strength today, oh God, for Ryan's mom, his siblings, his children, oh God, his friends, his neighbors, God, we ask today, oh God, that you would comfort their heart and you would give them your peace today, that you would be able to, they will be able to face today, tomorrow, and the days that lay ahead for them. Lord, we thank you. Father, we thank you for the friends and the neighbors and the relatives who've gathered together today to bid farewell. We pray this service would be a source of strength and a source of blessing to them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Remain standing with us. We invite Minister Gerald, and he's going to come and lead us in some worship.
Praise the Lord. In your program, there are two songs, When the Road is Called Up Yonder, in the Sweet By and By. We want to sing those songs this morning. I would like you to join with me this morning as you would sing those songs. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning brings eternal pride and fear. When the Savior Lord shall guide us over on the other shore, and the road is full of yonder again. When the road is called up yonder, when the road called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, again. On that bright light cloud this morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection shed, and his chosen one shall gather home beyond the sky, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love again. Then when all of life is over and the work done of this planet, and the road is all up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the road yonder, when the road is all up yonder, when the road is gone up yonder, when the road is gone up yonder, and sing on that bright and glorious morning, that cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share. The one shall gather over on the other sky, and the road is gone up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 there's a land that is there right now, and by faith we can see it afar. We shall live on that hill before God.
give him praise. We give him praise this morning. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. To the family, we want to sing this song, True It All. I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God amidst the difficult times, the trying times. We need to learn to trust in Jesus. Portion of scripture, Psalm chapter 23,
It was a Psalm of David. And it said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Before we hear from God's servant, I want to invite Risha, the sister of late Ryan, who's going to come at this time and do the eulogy for us.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Risha, the smaller sister of Ryan Mutura. He was also known as Mango, as most of you all would have known him as. Ryan was born on the 3rd of July, 1981, to our parents, Bina and the late Cyril Mutura. He was a second-born sibling, the first being Dale, third Karen, and lastly, myself. Ryan attended the Cedrus Anglican School, then went to Cedrus Composite School. He grew up in the same village of Wadsworth Village, Cedrus. Ryan, from a young age, was always hardworking. Early mornings in his youth, he used to be at the beach assisting the fishermen in preparation for going out to work. We know it as jostling. As he grew older, he started to work with the Ministry of Health Insect Vector, where his co-workers treated him like a brother. Ryan, the father of three boys, Rion, Chiron, and Nyron, loved his children more than his life itself. They meant everything to him, and he worked hard to take care of each one of them. Today, if we are going to celebrate Ryan's life, let's do it the way my brother lived. Full of joy, with lots of special moments and memories. This morning, up to 4 a.m., we sat together with his closest friends and families to put together this eulogy, where we tried to recall the fond memories of Ryan. It was so much to remember, real files blessed too, and even at times, we were left with no words. Ryan was also called Lion by my father. How did he earn that nickname? When Ryan was younger in his youth days, he always wanted to be fit and strong. He had a length of drill pipe, and on mornings and evenings, he made it his duty to use this for weightlifting. That is where he earned that name, Lion, because Daddy used to say he played strong man. I remember when we went to peak camp exercising, he used to feel so ashamed and run behind a fig patch in the back. Ryan was also known as Mango. Honestly, I cannot say how this name came about, but he was mainly known as Mango by many. Hopefully, I will get to know why this nickname came about. Ryan always greeted people with a smile. He was a humble, handsome, and caring gentleman. He was a family man who loved and enjoyed family time. He loved his parents, siblings, kids, nieces, nephews, relatives, and friends endlessly. He also grew a close relationship with his in-laws, Darren, Anita, and Karen. Even all the pets loved Ryan. He had a special heart. Ryan grew up closely with Dale, his cousin, Tony, and neighbor, Naren. they encountered so many fun childhood memories that will never be forgotten. His sister came along and they developed a close relationship growing up. But I came 6 years after, which made me the spoiled child. I remember him loving to play scratchback. That was our night game. So it was Dale scratching mine, so I scratching Ryan, then Ryan scratching Karen back. And on our two joint beds. And after, we had to turn around and scratch again. Ryan also loved to cook. He had a love for food and his belly. And if it's one thing, he always maintained a clean house and environment. One thing though, Ryan was afraid of cockroaches. Big as he was, he never went close to them. Imagine Ryan working health, but had to call on his partner Naren or son Rion to get rid of any cockroaches he saw. They had a time frightening him with it as well. My brother also grew up with one of our uncles, Naren, and our cousins. They had a lot of special memories to cherish. Ryan also grew close with another friend, Sasha. It's only today I hear that she was a troublemaker, where Ryan and Naren always had to bail her out. I also want to make mention of his Lyman crew, Dale, Naren, Cliff, Donnie, Fatman, and many others. You all know yourselves. One statement I can make about them was entertainment. Love to party, have drinks, and enjoyed every moment. The happiness in Ryan's life was overwhelming. He loved music. He had a passion for music, and this was learned from our eldest brother, Dale, from a young age. From a young age, they had loud music in my father's 120Y, named it Sting, and had a time playing music from place to place. When he bought his car, music was his priority. Ryan was truly a friend indeed. He was someone you could have confided in and always lent a listening ear. His home was always a welcoming one and made everyone comfortable. In October 2021, life took a turn for our brother. Though he was diagnosed with kidney disease, he fought a good battle. Even when the journey grew harder, he kept the faith and persevered. His ailment led him to start dialysis. He was hesitant about his decision, but after thought, for the sake of his children, he agreed to the treatment. In June 2022, he started dialysis at the Acropolis Center, where he was treated with love, care, and attention. He became more of a family than a patient to the nurses. Truly, Ryan fought a good fight, and we appreciated all that he had done in his life. Even through his illness, he continued showing love to all of us. Even at this point in life, he still loved to eat. Always calling my sister Karen to see what she was cooking, and when he was finished talking, he used to tell mommy he feeling to eat the same menu. She had to cook it. I don't know what about this, but he loved to eat raw rice. It was so irresistible that he used to have the kids hiding and bringing rice for him to eat, because if mommy knew this, she was going to quarrel. My brother was a true hero. In closing, I would like to convey thanks to all those that have supported my brother throughout this journey. Special mention to Donnie, Fatman, Mukesh, Nair, Sasha, and Biggie for taking the time to take Ryan to his dialysis sessions, as well as helping him move around. For making yourself available, I want to say thank you. Also to all that came to visit and check up on him, just naming a few, Pinky, Priya, Kitty and family, Uncle Paddy and Auntie Gracie, Vikash, Kavita and family, Avi, Fiona, and all the neighbors, I want to extend my sincerest thanks to you all. Even to the churches that prayed for my brother, Cedros Pentecostal, Cedros Presbyterian, and all the others, thank you, thank you. Now, to my mother, our mother. Words cannot express how grateful and thankful we are for you. You have been a blessing beyond measure to every one of us. You have been with Ryan from day one and never gave up. You were his encouragement and never left his side. I know he would have told you how much he loved you and how thankful he was for you being here. I know his favorite song he sang for you was Thank You, Mama. Mommy, you are the true description of a mother, full of love and patience. And we will always be here for you. I know this is hard, and it's no parent's wish ever to lose a child. But I want you to know that your children love you, and let us cherish the wonderful memories of Ryan together. Losing Ryan at 42 years, a young friend, brother, and son, is truly difficult to accept. Yes, we know that the pain is no more and the suffering has ended, but losing someone so special and loving has left a scar in our hearts. Ryan, go in peace, my brother. Your children will be well taken care of. We are thankful for all the great memories, laughter, and special moments we all shared with you. We will never forget you. I also want to thank God for allowing me the opportunity to pray with my brother at the hospital bedside where he gave his life to Jesus. Ryan, you will be missed. We love you. Let us remember the smiles and appreciate the time we got to spend with him. It's hard to say goodbye, but Ryan, fly high with the angels. Your life was a blessing, your memory a treasure, forever in our hearts. Rest in peace.
Thank you very much, Risha, for sharing the life of Ryan with us today. Shall we pray? Oh, Father, we thank you this morning, God, even for this day. This is truly the day that you have made. We will rejoice and we will be glad in it. Lord, we know it's a day where hearts are heavy. God, it's a sad day for this family to say farewell to their loved one. But God, you know all things, and all things are forever in your hand. We will not understand, God, why this has happened. But as we always say, oh God, you in your wisdom choose to call Ryan home at a time like this. Father, we thank you, O God, today for the peace that you would give, for the joy, Lord, that will flood our hearts knowing that he has gone to a better place. We thank you, Lord. We pray for those that remain behind, those of us that are here. Your word tells us, let the living take it to heart. God, we pray this morning that we who are alive, Lord, would look at our own life and take stock of how we are living and what we are doing with this life that you have given us. Father, help us today in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. I want to read a few verses of scripture taken from Psalm 90. We're not going to be long this morning. Moses wrote and he said, Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generation. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction, and sayest, return, ye children of men, for 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as with a flood. They are as asleep. In the morning they are like grass which groweth up. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withered. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by thy wrath are we troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are 70 years. For if by reason of strength they be 80 years, yet is thy strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off, and we fly away. Who knoweth the power of thy anger, even according to thy fear, so is thy wrath. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. So Moses says, teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. We now refer to Ryan as the late Ryan Matura. Time for him has ended. He's now late. And sooner or later, all of us will be called the late so-and-so. The late so-and-so. Why? Because life is short. Let's think a little bit about the brevity of life. Brevity of life. One of the most interesting things in our culture is that we are always conscious of time. What time is it? Some of you will be looking at your watch in a few minutes, pastor preaching too long. We have watches. All of us, most of us, wearing a watch because we are conscious of time. We have cell phones. Our cell phones have time on it. Whether we are in our offices or in our school, whether we are driving in our car or in the hospital or anywhere else we'll go, amen, there's always a clock nearby. Yeah? There's always a clock. Even in the church, there is a clock. But the beauty of it, we put the clock at the back of the church. So everybody here always looking back to see what time it is, how long we have again, amen. When will it all be over, amen. So there's almost a clock everywhere in our house. Anyhow you look, there is a clock right at our bedside. There is a clock, amen, that lights and tells us what time it is. And probably one of the most famous questions and common question that is asked is, what time is it? What time is it? Amen. So we're always checking on how time is going, how close to the end we are. Amen. Amen. All of us, we are very time conscious, sometime or the other. So here the man, Moses says, Lord, teach us to number our days. You know, if somebody asks you how old you are, you would say 25 years old. Or 40 years old. Ryan was 41, going on 42 years old. Amen. So we measure our year, our time in days of years. But notice what Moses says, teach us how to number our days. Not years. Teach us how to number our days. So he's saying, check your time, amen, in terms of days, not of years. Some of us have fewer days to live than others because some of us are older. Yeah? How many days do you have? How many days do I have? I don't know. Amen. Job 14 and verse 5 says, you have decided the length of our lives. You know how many months we would live. Amen. And we are not given a minute longer. Amen. So teach us how to number our days because life is short. No matter how old a person is when they die, we are always short. Whether they live to be 80, whether they live to be 90, whether they live to be 99, whether they live to be 15, we are always short when they die. Amen. Because life also seems so very short. You know? So very short. Amen. And life is short even at its longest. Amen. We wish we had more days that we could live longer. And some of us live as if we are here to stay forever. We lay down roots, man. Amen. And we think only of this life and how we live. Amen. We live in pleasure. We live without a thought of God and eternity. But sooner or later, we are going to slip into eternity like Ryan. Sooner or later, there'll be a service at your house, at your church, at my church. Amen. And when you look, amen, it might be somebody you know. People would gather, amen, when our time comes and when sickness comes, like when it came to Ryan, we try to push back the hand of death and we say, oh God, not yet, don't take him so soon. So we find ourselves rebuking death, amen, that young will die. But listen, the young die, the old die, death is certain. For the Bible says it is appointed unto man once to die. The Bible tells us that in Hebrews 9 and 27. It's only one time you're going to leave this earth. One time. Yeah? And if you think there are many deaths, let me ask you a question. How many of you have seen your dead relative after they die? For a matter of fact, if you see them, it's a nightmare. If you see them, you're running. If you're going down the road and you see them after they would have died, you're running. Huh? Because the Bible says it is appointed we die once. Once. You have one life to live here upon earth. Not two. So you have one chance to make it right. Amen. You have one chance to make it right. Life is so short. Every day carries 86,400 seconds. That's how much time one day has. Amen. There are 1,440 minutes in a day. Amen. In a year, there's 525 minutes. Amen. Listen, in a year, there are 31,536 seconds. Amen. In every year. How much of your life have you lived already? Some of us, we have lived most of our lives. Amen. And They usually say some people have one step in the grave and one step outside. You're close to death and dying, brethren. Amen. So we should number our days because, amen, of the brevity of life. Life is so short. And as I said on Thursday night, nobody could tell you when you're going to die. Sometimes not even the doctors have it right. They tell you have 2 days and you live for 6 months. They tell you have 6 months and you live for a week. Amen. Nobody can tell you when you are going to expire. Amen. God knows the length of our days, brethren. And death could sneak up upon us. Amen. Like a thief in the night and take us and snatch us out of this world. That's why we got to be prepared. We must be prepared for this thing called death and dying. And I'm not just talking about making sure that you don't leave your family in expense, because this is an expensive proposition. No, amen, to bury the dead, it's expensive. And you've got to make preparation for that too. But I'm talking about making preparation, amen, with your soul when you stand before God. John saw it in the book of Revelation. And he says, I saw, amen, both great and small, amen, stand before God. He says, the sea gave up their dead. Amen, the grave gave up their dead. And it stood before God, and God began to judge them. It is appointed unto man once to die, and after that you have to give an account of how you spend this life here on earth. You might be saying, well, this is my life, I could spend it how you want. Amen. You could say that. We could all say that. We all beat our chest and say, I'm a big man, I could live how I want. You know, children usually tell the parents when they reach a certain age, I am old enough and big enough. Amen. They're old enough and big enough. There are no key to turn their own door. Still living in their mother's house, as the case may. But they beat their chest and say, I'm big enough. Young people today in school, I say, I am my own man. Yeah, you could say that. But when you stand before God, you will give an account to God how you spent this life, how you lived this life. The Bible says we shall give an account for every idle word that we say. We're going to give account, because God is taking record of what we are doing with this life. And we will stand before God and give an account to God. And listen, amen, I hope we have a good defense. I don't know if it would stand before God. Amen. When God calls us to account, and the Bible tells us, as Moses said, amen, that we are given, amen, 70 years, amen, to live here upon earth, 70. 70 for all the days of our lives. He says 70, and if by reason of strength there be 80, yet it is their strength, amen, labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off. Job says, man days are few and full of trouble. Amen. Man that is born of woman, his days are few and full of trouble. Amen. We go through difficulties in this life. Amen. Life on earth is brief. Amen. It's brief, brethren. And we do not know how much time is allotted to us. Amen. Listen, some find their purpose, discover their gift. Amen. Live a life of fulfillment. Amen. Others wander through life. Amen. Listen. Amen. When we go to the cemetery, amen, we see so many people. So many people who would have wasted their lives, not live it for God, but live it for themselves, and went into eternity, amen, to face God, to face God. Let me say this, not only is life short, but God has a plan for your life. Even though life is brief and full of trouble, pleasures and struggles, amen, from conception to death, amen, we go through one thing after the next, amen, and people make all kind of statement. Listen, some people say, amen, when God was given blessing, like, God forget me, probably I missed the line, and we see all kind of things. But listen, amen, God never gives us more than we can bear. He never gives us more than we can carry. Amen. God will be unjust to give us more than we can bear. Even your own body. Your body can only take so much pain. And when it goes beyond that, you faint. Because your body can't take it. God gives us. Amen. Each one of us have our lot to bear. You know the old people used to say, go Paul Locke is not see Paul Locke. Yeah? And that's true. What is for you is for you. Amen. What is for somebody else is for somebody else. That's why the Bible tells us it's foolish for us to compare ourselves with ourselves and measure ourselves with our neighbor. Amen. Listen, what is for your neighbor is for your neighbor. What is for you is for you. Amen. Come on. Amen. And we all go through different things. Amen. We all go through our own struggle, brethren. Amen. But you made it. That's why you are here. You made it. That's why you are here today. Whatever you have gone through, you could recount some of the things that you have gone through. Amen. As you look at your life, amen, you might be saying it's not fair. And you know there was a man called the psalmist, and the psalmist looked at his life, and he looked at the wicked prospering, and he looked at the wicked, amen, they're going through, amen, listen, they're enjoying the best of life, and those that are living good, amen, it seems that they're finding it hard, but the Bible says, all that desire to live good shall suffer persecution. Come on, amen, listen, you have friends out there, and you're living it up with your friends, your real body buddies, but from the moment you decide to change your life, and say, I'm going to follow God, I'm going to do something good with my life now, amen, I'm going to cut off some of those things that I used to be doing, all your friends leave you. All that desire to live godly shall suffer persecution. But God has a purpose and a plan for your life, my friend. And I want to let you know it's a good plan. That God has a good plan. There is a devil that comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus says, I am come that you might have life, and that you might have that life more abundantly. Life in all its fullness. You might be saying, preacher man, you people in the church don't know, amen, what living is. Amen. Listen, my Bible tells me in the presence of God there is fullness of joy, and at his right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Serving God is the best thing that you could do with your life. Amen. And serving God now is the best thing that you could do with your life. Don't wait till it's too late. The Bible says too late shall be the cry for some people. Amen. Because they wait too long. And some of you young people listening to me here today, amen, you're wasting your life away. You're giving the best years of your life, amen, to the devil. The best years of your life to the devil. You waste it on pleasure. You waste it on alcohol. You waste it on drugs. That it damages up your system. It eats out at you. Amen. Listen, the devil lied to you and tell you that it will make you well. It will give you a head. Amen. That's what they tell you. The devil lies to you. But Jesus says, the thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But he says, I am come that you might have life, and that you might have it more abundantly. Life in all its fullness. God knows how you should live, because you were created to worship God. You were created for that one purpose, that is to bring honor and glory unto God. And until you find that, you will never ever be happy. You will never find true joy. Amen. God has a plan and a purpose. Amen. For your life. And you must play a part. Amen. Hear what the word of God says. Before I formed you in the belly, I knew you. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee. Amen. Jeremiah walked and worked with God. And he achieved his purpose. God has a plan and a purpose for your life. Amen. God has placed you here. Not just to make up numbers. Neither he has placed you here to catch you nene, but God has placed you here for a purpose, and that purpose is that you will worship him and that you will serve him all the days of your life. Life is brief. Death is inevitable. Amen. Amen. Death is inevitable. You have an enemy that stands to steal, to kill and destroy your destiny. Amen. But he could only succeed if you allow him to. Stop blaming people and stop even blaming the devil for everything that is happening in your life. Amen. Listen, I'm here to tell you this morning that even though there is an enemy, yet God has given us a Savior. Amen. And you need to believe in him and you need to accept him, as John 3 and verse 16 says. Amen. Jesus says, amen, that he came so that we could have life, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Amen. If we believe on the Lord, then we will have everlasting life. The Bible says, he that have the Son have life, and he that have not the Son does not have life, but the wrath of God abide in him. Don't let the devil steal your joy. Don't let him steal your purpose, brethren. Amen. But follow the Lord Jesus Christ, and so you would have life and have it more abundantly. Number your days. Know that life is short and death is inevitable. You are going to meet it one day. Can't run, you can't hide. You could pin up, you could prop up. Amen. You could do all kind of things. Amen. To keep your life going. But there comes a time when your organs say, I can't carry you anymore. And it's time. It's time. Ryan's time came. His time came. Amen. His body couldn't go on any longer. Amen. His time came. But you know, my friend, even though life is short and death is inevitable, I want to let you know that eternal life is available in our brief life. Amen. That we are here, 3 score and 10. Some may even go over that. Amen. Our lifestyle on earth determines where we spend our eternity. The choices that we make on this side of eternity determines where we are going to spend our eternity, my friend. Amen. I want to say that again. Eternal life is available. Amen. Eternal life. Every one of us born here, every one of us sitting here, we will live forever. There's a part of us that will exist into eternity. Amen. Every one of us, we are here preparing for eternity. And that's what we are doing. Our life is made up of choices, and every choice we make determines where we are going to spend eternity. The choice that you make today. Amen. Choose God and live for him, and you will enjoy eternal life. You cannot buy eternal life. Amen. The book of Romans tells us today, amen, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. It's a gift. Amen. It's not something that you could work for. It's not something, amen, so you balance off the evil by doing something good. It doesn't work that way. It's a gift that God has given us. We need to reach out and accept that gift of eternal life. Make that choice. Ryan made that choice. Several weeks ago, we met him right in this house. And we spoke to him about the Lord Jesus Christ. Yesterday, Risha was making sure, when you saw him the last time, you made sure that Ryan gave his heart to Jesus. Amen. So that when he slips into eternity, he will enjoy eternal life. Eternal life is a choice. It's a choice that you would make. God gave you life.
But God also gave you a will to choose. Nobody come in with a gun and put it by your head until you follow Jesus. Nobody doing that. The church ain't doing that. Amen. The church ain't doing forcing anybody to give their life to the Lord. It's a choice that you must make. Everybody has to make that choice. I can't make that choice for you. I didn't make it for my children. My four children made that choice for themselves. They had to come to the place where they said, I want Jesus. Amen. And they choose life over death. God has set it before us. There are two roads you can travel. You can travel the broad and winding road that Jesus says leads to destruction. And listen to what he says. He says, many on that road. Many are following that road. But he says that, amen, not only is broad and winding is the road, but he says straight and narrow is the road that leads to life. And few are on that road. My friend, life is short. Teach us how to number our days. Number your days, my friend. How long do you have here upon earth? Huh? For some people, sooner or later, time would be called for us. And we would be gone. We would go into eternity. We would leave this life. And then we face God. When we face God, amen. Listen, our choices will determine if we will hear, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Or if we will hear, depart from me, I know you not, into the lake of everlasting fire. Some people say it's unfair for God to do that. God doesn't do that. It's not God that is doing that. It's you that make the choices as to where you're going to spend eternity. My prayer is, friends, is that you would make the right choice and you would say yes to Jesus. You could turn him away. That's your choice. But you could say yes to him. Lord, amen. The Bible tells us it's good for us to be here today. It's good for us to be here to remind the living. This service is more about us than it is about Ryan, eh? Because we can't do anything for Ryan again. We have done what we, but it's about us here to remind us that we are just passing through. Just passing through, friends. Amen. And sooner for some people, later for others, we will hear the call. Amen. Time will be called and we wouldn't hear tick-tock anymore. Teach us how to number our days. Those of you that have a watch, some of you have a minute, a second hand on it, and it keeps moving. As long as the battery is working, it keeps moving. As long as you keep it warmed up, it keeps moving. And as you look at that, time is passing. It doesn't wait. They say time waits on no man. It is just going. And when you lose that time, you never get it back. One man says, time is the stuff that life is made of. That's all we have, is time. And soon, it will be called and you will be late. I encourage you today to say yes to Jesus. Just close your eyes with me this morning. God wouldn't be pleased if we leave here and do not give you an opportunity to say yes to him. No better place to say yes than here. We have an opportunity to do that. You don't know if you will ever get that opportunity again. Who knows, next time we might be at your home. You might be sitting in a chair like this at your funeral. When you stand before God and God asks you, what have you done with my son? What will you say to him, my friend? Say, Lord, I never heard. God will remind you, Ryan's funeral. You were sitting right there. And the preacher threw out the question, make your choice what you will do with your life. The person sitting next to you can't choose for you. The person sitting behind you can't choose for you.
your neighbor next door. Because some of you would wait to see if your neighbor lift their hand. Yeah? When you stand before God, it's you on your own. God will call you by name. And he will ask you, what have you done with my son, Jesus? God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, one of a kind. There's none other like Jesus. That's what the only begotten means. One of a kind. And God gave him so that if we believe, we will not perish, but we will have everlasting life. That's all you need to do. Believe, trust Jesus. Ask him to forgive you, cleanse you, and wash you. And he will come into your heart. He will save you just as you are today. He's saying, come just as you are. Let not Ryan die in vain. Amen. Say yes to him today. Come just as you are and surrender your life to Jesus. He is the way, he is the truth, and he is the life. Exclusive. He is the way. No man comes to the Father but by me. Will you say yes to him this morning? Would you give him your heart? Give him your soul, like Ryan did, so that we could see him in eternity. Yeah? Some of you used to line with him, good friends, make jokes. If you want to see Ryan again, then you must surrender your life to Jesus, like Ryan did, with your heads bowed and your eyes closed. If you want him to come into your heart this morning and forgive you of your sins, to say this prayer with me. Let it be your words. Just say after me, Lord Jesus, I come to you this morning recognizing that I am a sinner and I'm lost. But Lord, I've heard your word and I believe that Jesus died for my sins. So I ask you to forgive me for every sin that I've committed. Come into my heart, wash me with your blood, and make me clean. Lord, I pray that you will give me this abundant life. I pray that you will give me this eternal life so that I will not perish, but see you in heaven. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me today. Praise God. Keep your head bowed and your eyes closed. Father, we thank you today for every person that said this prayer and meant it. We pray for them, oh God. Young and old alike would make that choice for eternal life today, Lord. Let none perish, but let all be saved. We know that this is your will and your plan for our lives. So even though life is short and death is inevitable, we know that eternal life is available. We pray that we would accept you. Oh God, bless us today. In Jesus' name, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. In a few minutes, we're going to pray for the family. We're going to have a viewing of the body, and then we leave for the Mosquito Creek, for the final place where we will commit his body to the fire. Praise God. But before we do so today, pray for the family. We wonder if there's anybody that wants to give some expressions, short expressions. Time is of essence. If you want to say a few words today, you could come now quickly. All right, if you want to do so. Ryan's friends, anybody want to come and say a few words, we will allow you to do so now.
Good day, everyone.
Woo.
What a day. It's one of the toughest days I think I'm experiencing in my entire life. I'm going by my nephew. Believe me, I'm going too soon, my brother. Believe all of us, my friend. And I said, come down, see you. So I stop right there and just sit down over the road and I call you out. Sit down. Come here for juve at 2 o'clock in the morning. You're waking up, you're waiting for me to come down here, bro. He's one going today, brother. Stop. Last time I was here, I saw you. You were standing, we was chatting. And then after that, my friend, you just went all the way down. I pray to God to keep you with us. I think God have better plans for you. Fry high up there, man. Palco up there. Your grandparents on both sides up there waiting for you. They'll take good care of you up there. Thank you for all and everything that you have done for us. Thank you, nephew. Thank you. I can't done say thank you. Your boys will be taken care of. Mom will be taken care of. Everybody will be taken care of. Your friends here, so much of us grew up together. Everybody's here today. Wishing you farewell, wishing you goodbye. Everybody with heavy hearts. It's a good one, and you didn't deserve to go so early, but God has its plan for everyone. Go stay with Palco and stay with your grandparents, nephew. And everyone else who's here today sharing this most difficult day in our entire life. Those who don't know me, by the way, I'm being a last brother. In the bottom of my heart, I want to say thank you to each and every one of us for being here today, for showing us support, for showing this family support. You guys have no idea how much this is received by us in this very difficult day. My nephew, goodbye. Goodbye, my nephew. Rest in peace.
Thanks, bro. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. But we want to pray for the family. We're going to ask the family to stand. Come closer to us. For the boys. Praise the Lord. Some of you stand on this side. Come
guys.
Praise. Come here. Come right here. Be down. All the others. Praise God.
Why you want to put them where I could see everybody's face? Like, more on that side. Yeah, what am I wrong?
Yeah. Praise God. So just join hands as we pray today. Some of us, we may not understand and what they are going through. Some of us who have been there know what it's like, know the pain that they're feeling. That's why God has given us a comforter to come and comfort us from inside out. Amen. The Holy Spirit, that He will come and comfort you. He promised to be a father to the fatherless, a husband to the widows. These three boys stand here today. Amen. And I heard what many of you said. Praise God that you're going to be, that we are all going to be here for them. That they wouldn't be without a role model. They wouldn't be without anything. We would stand and make sure that they are taken care of. Amen. And we pray today that God will strengthen this mother. She has done her best for him. And we thank God for her. Amen. That she would have done. Amen. I remember we came and we said, and we were praying with him, and he said, you know, I want to go. I want to go. Amen. Like he was tired of what he was facing. Now God has taken him into his bosom. Stand with us as we pray for them today. Stand, everybody, as we take them in our hearts. Praise God. Lord, we thank you today. We thank you for this family that is standing here, oh God. You know their hearts. You know their hurts. You know their pain. You know their grief. Oh God, what they are going through this point in time, Lord. You are aware, oh God, and
Your word tells us that you are the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles. God, Lord, this family, oh God, has found themselves in a difficult place, oh God. But you never give us more than we can carry. We thank you today, oh God, for Mommy. We thank you, Lord, for the strength that you have given to this woman. God, to carry this family, Lord. In the name of Jesus, she stood with Ryan, oh God, through thick and thin. She was there with him in and out, oh God, to the hospital and back, to the nursing home and back, oh God. Lord, you know what she would have gone through, her time, her treasure that she would have given, oh God. I pray that you would reward her, oh God, today, and you would bless her and comfort her at a time like this in the name of Jesus. Let your strength be her strength today, oh God. We thank you, Lord. We lift up Dale before you, oh God. We pray for him, oh God. Help him, oh Lord, to stand with his mama, to stand, oh God, with his sisters and his nephews today, oh God. Lord, he will be counted on today, oh God. Help him, Lord, we pray today. God, we know he doesn't say much, but you know the hurt and the pain that he's feeling right now. Oh God, we thank you for him. We pray today for Karen and Risha, oh God. Help them, Lord. Help them. Help them, Lord. Lord, as they call on you, oh God, soothe them from the inside out. Let them feel that balm of comfort coming over them, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh God, that you would bless them and keep them. Lord, we pray for the boys today as they stand here to say goodbye to their father, oh God. Lord, you promised to be a father to the fatherless. They would know that they have an heavenly father that will look over them, oh God. We pray that these children, Lord, wouldn't be left on their own, oh God, but they will be given the proper guidance, oh God, Lord, so that they will make something of themselves today, Lord, and they will be able, oh God, oh my God, to stand up and be counted in Cedrus today. Let them not be another statistic, oh God. We pray in the name of Jesus. We pray for his nephews, his nieces, his cousins, oh God, that's standing here today, oh God. We pray for them, oh God. You would help them through this day, this time, oh God. We pray you would look over them, oh God. Let them not faint, oh God, but we pray that they will be strong in the name of Jesus. Keep them, oh God, in the days ahead, in the weeks ahead, oh God. Keep them, Lord, we pray for his friends, his close friends, oh God. Help them, Lord. We pray today, his co-workers, bless them. Bless this community, the community of Boswell today, oh God. Father, we thank you. We commit them into your hands today, oh God. And we ask that your peace would rest upon them. That peace that passes all understanding today. Oh God, we thank you. And we commit them into your hands. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And amen. Praise God. God bless you. You may have your seats. Praise the Lord. We want to thank you for being here today on behalf of my family, my wife, kids, the Pentecostal church leaders and members. We want to extend our deepest sympathies and condolences to Risha and the family. Today we continue to pray for you that God will give you strength and God will give you his peace. Amen. Praise God. We want to give you an opportunity to view the body. We're going to ask the immediate family to remain seated. So we want to do it orderly and quickly. We're going to ask you to come this way. You view the body and you go this way. All right? Praise God. So we're going to ask. All right?
Oh my, I wish to be.
Ryan.
Praise the Lord. So we can ask you, we want to do it orderly. There's a condolence book on the table in front there. You can sign the book. Alright? Praise the Lord. So we want to do this as quickly as we can. Praise the Lord. Alright, so we invite you to come. If you want to spray some perfume, there's a bottle of perfume. Just don't spray it on his face. If you want to, praise God. Alright, let's just. Alright, so come this way, view the body. Stand at the side so that they can just come through and view the body. Alright? So we have the family to remain seated. We'll give you an opportunity, right, to say your goodbyes.
scene. Open up the gates for me, reminisce some time. Black day took my friend, try to black it out, but it plays again. When it's real, feelings hard to conceal. Can't imagine all the pain I feel. You can't get in here, happy crap. I know you still living your life after death.
Yeah. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do that.